It was ladies' night at Elder Ag and Turf in East Palestine. Fun and informative speakers discussed farming techniques, 4-H, even equipment maintenance. Helpful information to leave winter behind and embrace the upcoming warm weather. I'm here at Elder Ag and Turf in East Palestine, and Joyce was born and raised in Elder, and this has been in the family business for how many years?
Over 60 years.
And Joyce invited me out for ladies' night, and I think this is a terrific idea.
Thank you.
So what do you accomplish? What, it's been 12 years since you've been hosting this?
Yes.
And the ladies, what do you hope to teach them each and every year?
Well, it started as we didn't want there to be any stupid questions, and women, a long time ago, were concerned about asking those type of questions in front of men or of a man. So we started a ladies' night so there would be no stupid questions. So they come and they ask us how to service their own lawnmower, because many women do. And we've been doing it. We include farming information, master gardeners. We've had people who raise animals over the year. Something different every year because we have a wide variety of customers.
I think it is such a terrific idea. And with the hellacious winter we have experienced, it is like a breath of fresh air that spring, you know, it's right around the corner.
Right. Yes, we try to do it every spring to get everybody geared up for planting and lawn mowing and all those wonderful things that we do outside.
Is John Deere pretty easy to service for the women? I mean, is it pretty cut and dry?
Yes, and that's one of the things we show. We go over 14 points and show absolutely how easy it is to change your own spark plug or check the level of your mower deck or many other things. And all that information we have available for anybody who wants it.
One of our speakers for Ladies Night is Dawn, and she is here from Dandelion Lane Farm in Latonia. And you have the designation of being certified
naturally grown.
And what is the difference between that and organic?
Well, it's pretty much the same. The only thing is that we are not certified by the USDA. We still follow the same practices. We use no chemicals, no pesticides, no herbicides. Everything that we use is derived naturally.
And when you do that, how do you keep, what products do you use to keep the pests away that are natural?
Well, you could do some companion planting, like you can plant borage with your tomatoes, and they keep away the greenhorn worms. And you can plant marigolds around your vegetables.
So that does work. That is not an old wives' tale.
They are natural repellents, as well as garlic works too.
And what do you do when you begin the planting season? You know, what seeds do you use, and what plants and varieties do you grow?
Well, we start all of our seeds in the basement. All of our plants are started by seed. We use heirloom seeds. And I like that because heirloom is a seed that is passed down generation after generation. I have some that, you know, come from a plant that's over 200 years old, being the mother plant. I like that because of the fact that we know that they are not genetically modified. And that's really important to us, because who wants to eat something that Roundup cannot kill?
Mary Lou is one of the ladies that attended Ladies Night, and you were a big winner.
Yes, I was. I was really surprised.
Now, is this your first Ladies Night?
No, I've been here several times.
Why do you keep coming back?
Because of all the fellowship that we have here. We know a lot of the people, and I just live maybe 5 minutes from here.
So you're an East Palestine resident?
No, I'm New Waterford.
New Waterford, yes. Excuse me. Now, Sherry, is this your first Ladies Night?
No. I've been here, coming here for a bunch of years now, yeah.
And you are a push mower, you said, not a tractor.
Yeah, I push mow.
Do you garden?
Yeah, I like to garden. I like to plant flowers also, yes.
So what did you take away? What was your favorite part of this evening?
I enjoyed you being here.
Oh, you know what? I just love this show. We'll come back next year too, okay?
Yes.
Well, the Columbiana County 4-H Queen also is here tonight, Courtney Hefner. Now, Courtney, what are you going to do during your reign?
Well, for right now, I'm just trying to get out into the community as much as possible and to promote 4-H. It really is a great organization that builds leadership skills in the youth today and gives them opportunities to do great community service projects and really just make a lot of wonderful and lasting friendships.
And has anybody been removed as a 4-H queen, to your knowledge, has anybody ever done anything that they have, like, you know, embarrassed the 4-H organization?
Not that I know of, no.
I hope not, because I've not heard much scandal. You have a very good organization,
yeah,
4-H.
We really are a group of really great kids.
You are. And what are your intentions? What do you plan to do after this is all done?
Well, for right now, I'm a senior at Crestview High School. So in the fall, I want to go to Kent State University and major in speech pathology.
Well, you are a wonderful, wonderful representation. You really are. You are. You do a really nice job, and you're so poised. And I love that. I got to tell you, can we get a picture taken? Because I want to get a picture of me with
Queen. Yeah, absolutely.